The governor is the constitutional head of the state executive. But in actual working, the chief minister is the chief executive. The president nominates the governor, whose term of office is 5 years. What should be the qualification of a person who is considered for the post of a governor? 1. He should be a citizen of India. 2. He should have completed 35 years of age. And 3. He should not be a member of parliament or a member of any state legislative assembly. What are the powers that the governor of a state has? After every legislative assembly election, the governor appoints the chief minister. Based on the chief minister's advice, the governor appoints the rest of the ministers. Whenever an old chief minister loses his majority in the legislative assembly, the governor will have to step in and appoint a new chief minister based on the scenario in the legislative assembly. The governor is supposed to read every bill passed by the state legislative assembly and approve it. Otherwise, the bill passed by the assembly cannot be implemented. When the president dissolves the state government and imposes the president's rule in the state, the governor takes charge of the administration of the state. During a president's rule, the state does not have an elected government. The central government runs the state through the governor. The chief minister is the key figure in the state government. The governor appoints the leader of the party or the group that gains majority in the election for legislative assembly as the chief minister. During every election, you would have seen politicians claiming that they would implement certain schemes if they became a chief minister. They organize huge rallies, print so many advertisements, and spend lakhs of rupees for their campaign. But why? Why do these people want to be a chief minister? What are the powers possessed by a chief minister? Well, firstly, the governor appoints all the ministers on the advice of the chief minister. The chief minister gets to choose who becomes a minister in the government. Nobody can question him as to why an MLA was chosen or not chosen as minister. That is a lot of power, you see. In addition to this, the chief minister has the power to allocate the departments to the ministers or change their departments or completely drop them from the government. The chief minister also plays an important role in maintaining good relationship between the center and the state. The governor is the constitutional head of the state executive. The president nominates the governor, whose term of office is 5 years. But in actual working, the chief minister is the chief executive. The governor is supposed to read every bill passed by the state legislative assembly and approve it. The chief minister is the key figure in the state government. The governor appoints the chief minister. The chief minister has the power to allocate, change the departments to ministers, or completely drop them from the government. The chief minister also plays an important role in maintaining good relationships between the center and the state.
If you like this video and want to watch many more amazing videos like these, like and subscribe to our channel now.